Sequester is in full effect. The forced budget cuts are being felt all over the country. In fact, the Supreme Court says it's concerned that critical legal services could be affected in the cutbacks. The justices also warn that the cuts raise the risk of innocent people being wrongly convicted. As part of the sequester, the court system has started cutting salaries, court security, and federal public defenders. Now, those cuts are being felt here in the metro as well, at the home of former president. KMBC 9's Haley Harrison finds out that a couple popular Harry Truman attractions are closing, and another one is cutting back. Haley?
Well, Len, those changes take effect in just 10 days. Now, we've got a tour group just getting ready to go here into the Harry S. Truman site. But earlier this afternoon, we caught up with some folks who had driven a very long way to come see the Truman Home and the Noland House across the street. And they tell me they were very disappointed to hear this news.
We love independence. We love the history here. We love Harry Truman and what he represented.
Standing outside a national treasure, St. Charles native Becky DeFilippo and her relatives from Pennsylvania learn they're among the last visitors to the Noland home, where Harry Truman courted his wife Bess.
What a loss. And who cares about that loss? We do. But do our politicians and politicians in Washington care about it? I don't know. It seems to me that there could be cutbacks elsewhere.
Sequestration cuts will soon affect this and other presidential attractions in town. The Truman Home across Delaware Street will lock up 110 days a year. Starting March 24th, it closes Sundays, Mondays, and federal holidays. The recently reopened Noland Home will close, as well as the Truman Farm Home in Grandview. The Park Service estimates 5,000 visitors will be turned away from these metro area attractions each year. Tourists are calling on Washington to take notice.
We've been wanting to come up here.
Joyce Harrington's family drove from southern Illinois to soak up the history while they still could.
I liked him. I respected him. I was a little girl, but I remember.
And these sites generate more than $1.9 million in local economic impact every single year. We'll have more on how all of this is going to affect mom and pop businesses here in Independence coming up tonight at 6. Reporting live, Haley Harrison, KMBC 9 News.
Thank you, Haley. The National Park Service Visitor Center on Main Street in Independence will also be closing more than 100 days a year.